The State Department is considering closing down the American embassy in Libya. As the U.S. clears the decks for sanctions and perhaps even military action, that will, as the White House puts it, compel Qaddafi to cease and desist.
Any strategy to compel a leader attempts to put at risk the things that he values. His power, his money, his family.
Among the options the U.S. is considering, U.N. sanctions, freezing or seizing Qaddafi's assets, banning Libyan officials and airliners from international travel, suspending exports to Libya, all of which take time, none of which go for the jugular.
For a trade embargo to work with Libya, you would have to consider seriously cutting off trade in oil. But the trick here is that the world needs Libyan oil.
Other options involve intervention, sending in relief supplies, broadcasting to the Libyan people, creating a no-fly zone over part or all of the country to prevent Qaddafi from using his air force against the protesters.
It may take military force or intervention of some sort to defend the Libyan people and the protesters and to remove Qaddafi from power.
And although no one will talk about it, there has to be at least a plan for doing what the U.S. tried to do when it bombed Qaddafi's tent back in 1986.
And if the human carnage is dramatic enough, that there might be a sense that you have to take Qaddafi out.
That may be the only way to deal with a dictator who has said he intends to fight to the death. Katie?
David Martin. David, thanks very much.